Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. I welcome you to a set of QNX training videos for our QNX support within the Trace32 debugger. My name is Rudi Dienstbeck. Hi, that's me. I'm responsible at Lauterbach for auto support within our debugger and especially also for QNX support. QNX support, also known as awareness within our Trace32 debugger. So everything what we support additionally to our standard debugging features to support also systems that run QNX on the target. This will be actually a complete set of training videos. It won't be marketing videos. I will give you several information about internals, about how the things work, but of course also a feature overview. And I will give you live videos. Actually, this will be the only presentation, the only PowerPoint presentation that I'll give to you. Everything else will be live videos, so that you can really see how the things work. So the QNX awareness actually is included in each Trace32 software. You have to enable it, but there is no extra cost for it. And if you have the Trace32 software installed, you can find it in the Trace32 installation directory. I'll show it to you. CT32 is the standard installation path of our software. And if you go down to demo, and then the architecture, in this case ARM kernel, you will find a subdirectory called QNX. And this actually contains all files, all additional software that you need for a QNX software. I'd like to point you to a different directory as well, which is our PDF directory, which contains our documentation. And there is a documentation called Autos QNX stop and Autos QNX run.pdf. Let's look into the. And here you can see the documentation, the help file for our QNX awareness, also known here as Autos Debugger for QNX. So everything what I'm telling you, you can also look up in the manuals. Let's close that one and go back. You already saw there are two manuals because there is a stop mode and a run mode debugging. Actually, I'd like to point out the difference between those modes. So first to the QNX stop mode debugging. It's a debugging that is handled completely by the debug hardware, which means it runs through the JTAG logic. And actually, there is no target debug agent necessary, so no additional software inside the target is necessary to do that stop mode debugging. No instrumentation actually is necessary. I will use the instrumented QNX kernel in my presentations later, but this has other reasons. I'll tell you then why, but it's actually not necessary for the stop mode debugging. If you run onto a breakpoint and the breakpoint halts, then the complete system halts, which means not only one process, but really the complete system, which means kernel, processes, drivers, everything halts actually. But you can debug everything actually which runs on your target. You can debug the startup routine, you can debug drivers, processes, libraries, and all at once. You can even debug several processes, several libraries at once. So this is a very convenient way to debug the complete system. And if you do a performance analysis, for example with our real-time trace, you can do that on real production code, which means not the instrumented code and not the instrumented kernel. So that you are really doing a performance analysis on the real systems that will run then later on your real hardware. Then on the other side we have the QNX run mode debugging. In this case, Trace32 uses the pdebug agent on the target as debugging agent. You may know pdebug is a standard QNX debugging agent on the target. The communication is actually done via Ethernet, so today's 32 in this case talks via Ethernet directly to the target and directly to PDBug. And in this case it's just standard PDBug debugging, so if halted on a breakpoint, only the process that is controlled by PDBug will halt, everything else keeps running. So really one process is halted and the kernel, other processes and all the drivers keep running. So this can only be used for debugging processes and not for kernel or for the startup routine. So just to summarize again, stop mode debugging means debugging the complete system, and if run on a breakpoint the complete system halts. Run mode debugging means you are debugging only one process, and if running on a breakpoint only this process halts but everything else keeps running. Okay, now heading for the live demos. I will do my live demos on a Panda board with a TI OMAP 4430. The OMAP 4430 chip actually has two Cortex A9 MP core cores inside. So this is an SMP system, as we will see later. And maybe I'll show you the systems. Here we have our target board. It's a small board actually. Here in the middle, this is the OMAP chip. And you may see that there is an additional board on it that is made by Lauterbach just to enable tracing, real-time trace. You won't need that for debugging only, but if you want to do real-time trace, that one is needed on that board. For debugging actually we will use our PowerDebug 2 interface, looks like that, with an JTAG cable on it, and this one is then connected to the target. For tracing, real-time trace, we will use a PowerTrace 2 system, which actually looks like that. Well, a little bit bigger than the other one. And this is the connection actually then to the ETM port for catching real-time traces. So that's what we will use for our systems. And this is the sequence of videos that I will record. The first one is the introduction video, which you are seeing right now. And then we will go through different phases, like creating an image, a QNX image for debugging, attaching the debugger to a running QNX target, or downloading and starting a QNX image with Trace32. We will have a look at the complete setup script, then the QNX resource displays, how to debug processes, how to debug libraries with Trace32. We will have a look at the SMP support. Then at the dynamic performance measurement, which is a performance measurement you can do with the debugger only, you don't need a trace for that. QNX has a nice feature called Trace Logger, and there is a special functionality within Trace32 to support this Trace Logger. And then we'll go to the real-time trace-based performance analysis, where you can do a task runtime analysis and a function runtime analysis. I'll show you the run mode debugging, and at last I'll show you an integrated run and stop mode debugging where you can do both simultaneously. And that's actually the last thing. So that's for the introduction. Let's head on for the second video, which will be then about creating a QNX image that is suitable for debugging. See you for the next video.